عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المخلوق وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. أما بعد، respected dignitaries, especially my dear friend Shahid Ahmed Khan, who was also with me for civil service training and a promising candidate, and other dignitaries on the list. Especially the aspiring candidates. My topic is my journey from Madarsa to UPSC. I can remember that 22 years back, that time after my fifth standard of school, my parents, especially my uncles, decided to send me to a madrasa. The problem was some unfortunate things happened in the family, and the family was unable to give me my proper education in the schools because of their poverty and poor conditions. That's why they sent me to a madrasa. After that, a long 12 years I have been in a madrasa, studying Quran, Hadith, Usul al-Fiqh, and related theological subjects. So that long 12 years defined my life, defined my strategies, and ultimately, I don't know where I have to go. I think you may know, actually madrasa is a word in simple meaning, it is a place where education is given. All the place where education is given is a madrasa. It is a, in Arabic, it is a word for, you may know that, maf'ul. It is a place where education is given. So all the universities is a madrasa. All the schools are madrasas. And even in the medieval times, when Islam has a golden time of opportunities, there was a madrasa in Nizamiya, Madrasa Nizamiya, which was the university of the universities at that time. And there were madrasa in Cordova, which led Europe to Renaissance. And even in India, in the Mughal times, even in Hyderabad at the time of Nizams, there were good madrasas. So it was a prize for education is given, a prize, a center for excellence, everything. But unfortunately, what happened, in the due course of time, due to a planned conspiracy from inside and outside the community, in India, especially by the British efforts, madrasa became an exclusive center of religious education. You may know that a diversion in our knowledge happened. It was a Himalayan blunder that made us frequently in the backward list. As per the Sachar committee, worse than SC and STs in the country. You know, that became madrasa on one side and center of modern education or schools on the other side. Madrasa became the center of only exclusively the religious education, and modern education is other side. So this type of a diversion when happened, it became always backward. It made us always backward. But recently, you may know that, understanding the crucial situation and the febrile confusion which the community lies ahead, some revenge studies started happening, especially in the Kerala model of madrasas. In Kerala, you may know that there are two types of madrasas. One is primary madrasas, which focus only 1 hour or 1 hour, 1.5 hour before school or after school. So there, it is complementary. There is no hindrance to modern education. One another type is advanced madrasas. It is exclusive religion, theologies are very thoroughly studied, and my madrasa was one of them. And even in that madrasa, recently it has started combining the best practices from international, modern, and also from religious. So, when I joined my madrasa, it was a starting stage of that time. When I was in my 18th years old, we were allowed to write in matriculate exam. we were allowed to write in open education SSLC exam. And it was followed by plus two also through open school we have registered. Following by, we have registered the Calicut University for BA English, BA English Language and Literature. So simultaneously, while qualifying for the postgraduate degree in Madrasa named Hassani, I got SSLC and plus two and degree through distance education or open education. So at that time, it was a revolution which was happening in Madrasa because something changes had started in struggling. And after that, I have a long 12 years. After a long 12 years, I came to the real world. What I am seeing, I have to earn for my family. The burden of my family was under my head. I searched many jobs, done many jobs, including the easy jobs were doing the madrasa teacher. I have done in 6 or 7 madrasas. I have been working for as a madrasa teacher, earning 3,000 per month or 2,000 per month. I have done even the job of marketing executive, which also gave me that time 3,000 per month. And after that, I have done a part-time diploma in journalism, which cracked me a job in a local newspaper, which also gave me some meager amount of 5,000 per month. So anyway, at that time, for a poor family, it was all in control. And I was in a safe journey was going on. You may heard that a ship is always safe in shore, but that was not, it was not built for that. The same like things, a human being is always, it is easy to be in safe zone, but, and it is very tough to be in risky zone. But only by being in a risky zone, we can make achievements and we can make results or we can create wonders. And it was my case also. I also selected to be in a risky zone and I changed some sort of strategies and I also jumped into the well of a UPSC. My source of inspiration was what I have studied in Madrasa. You may know one hadith, Waqila fil matlab man jadda wajad. It means that whoever try, it would be good. It was studied in the basics of madrasas, one tasawuf poem. And also by the, in Quran, it was clearly said that وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ. Whatever you can do and you can pray for me, I will do for you. So, to make a change, to be in a risky zone, to travel a less traveled one, you may know the poems of Robert Frost, Two Roads Diverged in a Yellow Wood. And what was happened ultimately, the less traveled one created more difference. So I also jumped in the well of UPSC without even know what is the basics of syllabus, what is the basics of swimming. And all وَمَنْ يَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ فَهُوَ حَسْبُهُ. It was, that was a source of my inspiration. So, tawakkul, if we are assigning all our duties to Allah, He will do all the things. So I also applied for UPSC for the first time. Even without no basics of the syllabus, what is to be written, what is the process, nothing I don't know. I remember that before 1 week of the exam, I called a coaching institute. I asked them, do you have a crack course for civil service because my exam is coming on the next week or the next of the next week. They asked me what type of person you are. And they called me for a camp, for 1 week camp, because they are giving that camp for the foundation course, fresh students. And that camp made me aware of the Madarsa procedures and syllabus of this exam. And that camp too, I was not manageable because that camp costed me 3,000. First I gave them 1,000 and after 2-3 days of the camp, I left because I have now more cash to give them. And anyway, that gave me the first base of civil service. And anyway, I trained to Ernakulam, one of the places in Kerala. I wrote the first time civil service and I returned to my room. I calculated based on the one of the answer sheets. I calculated my marks, and purely my marks was below zero, considering all the minuses, because the prelims of the civil services including minus also. So my marks started decreasing from zero. When it started decreasing from zero, I stopped calculating and then started doing my job also. But in my heart, I was never ready to give up. And the next year also, when exam came, I applied, I studied hard, but I failed in prelims itself the second time also. And the third year came, third year also I applied, I studied whatever I can possible, but that time also I have very beautifully failed in the third attempt also in the prelim itself. You may know that civil service has three steps, prelims, mains and interview, three steps are there. So if one person is failing in the prelims itself for third time consecutively, his all confidence and belief would be lost. And fourth time also it came, I applied, I studied hard, and I wrote the exam. At the fourth time also, I have miserably failed in prelims. And next it came, fifth year. Fifth year also I applied, I studied hard, but that time also I have miserably failed. So, five times consecutively failing in the prelims was happened in my life. You may think that what motivated me to write again? What I think, I thought was, considering me, nothing was to lose. Only what I have to get, it is a ray of hope, and as Iqbal says, to Shahi hai, parwaz hai, am tere saamne asman aur bhi hai. You are like a bird. You have nothing to lose, and your duty is to fly. And what you have to conquer is the seven ray of clouds and skies. So sky is the limit for a person who has nothing to lose. And again, I thought, what happened to all my failures? The fail, as APJ Abdul Kalam describes, is the first attempt in learning. But in my case, it was full attempt in losing. So after 5 days, I thought very seriously, what have to be done? Then I see a newspaper ad that from Hyderabad, there is a University of Manu, Maulana Azad National Urdu University. They are providing a free coaching for minority students. So I was thinking that I can utilize their accommodation, I can utilize their food, I can utilize their libraries, and I can study personally using their libraries and everything. And so I tried to Hyderabad. So at the sixth time, for a general category person, it was the last time. I studied, used their library, their arrangements, facilities, everything, and that time I have qualified prelims for the first time. I think simultaneously I was writing all other exams, because I was in very need of a job. I wrote 22 PSC exams, state PSC exams, but none of them I have qualified. And I also wrote SSC exam, but none of them qualified. And one job I have got was, it was in IB, Intelligence Bureau, there was a job of Assistant Central Intelligence Officer. I have qualified in their prelims, mains and interview. And my list was there in the final list. But waiting for 1 year, they have just sent me a letter that your character and conduct does not match with this job. So even that was a utter failure. So only my hope was getting something in UPSC. So sixth time I came here also. Here also you may know that in Manu it was some sort of problems happens. They also expelled me at the last stage of the course, telling me your presence and your hajar is not up to the standard. But anyway, at that time, only one person qualified from that institute, and that was me. And after that, I went to Jamia Millia for main studies. I selected my Malayalam as an optional paper for optional studies, and very easily, with God's grace, without much preparation, I got mains that time itself, and also the interview also I got, and I got the rank of 693. And Alhamdulillah, now I am an assistant director in the Ministry of Information, Press Information Bureau. Anyway, as being an OBC candidate, I have three more attempts. So first of my niyat, it is to be complete whatever rights you have. We have 9 attempts, so I am also trying to write next year to make a chance for improvement. Because you know that for every person, for getting some improvement, their skill and their challenges should be equal. So to make some challenges and to equal our skills for that challenges, we have to write again. So I am preparing for that. So first of foremost advice for you is that never give up. In UPSC, there is a chance of failures, because only 0.001% is winning out of the 10 lakh candidates appearing. So first of my advice is never give up. Every dog has a day, every candidate has a day. You have to expect that time. The second, in knowledge, as per the Islamic belief, there is no any kind of diversion. In hadith, even in Sahih Bukhari, the every hadith kitab, many of the hadith kitab starts with a particular one hadith. It is innamal amal binniyat. Every activity is judged as per the intention of the person. So if you are a faqir, or if you are doing a religious, if you are teaching a Quran, and your intention is to cheat another person, then it is not Islamic, or it is not religious. And if you are a scientist, you are doing some un-Islamic job, means it is not particularly related with Islam, but your intention is correct, to benefit some person, to deliver a person, to help a poor, then also you are judged as a good person, because your intention is correct. So, first of all, our intention should be correct. Our niyya, innamal amalu binniyya, our niyya should be correct. And the thirdly, in my own experience, I was dealing in Delhi for the last 1.5 years. The bureaucracy is always neutral. We were preaching that bureaucracy is discriminated, Muslims are discriminated, they will not get any post. Nothing is like that. If you have merit, and if you are competent enough, you can go to any corridor of power with your marriage. No need of any caste, no need of any community benefit, nothing. Only your merit would be evaluated in most of the places. There may be exceptions, but we should be always positive. And thirdly, 5 P's I can give you. That is, first one, it is the prayer. Your prayer is always makes you positive. And it is prayer, positive attitude, your perseverance, and your patience. Patience is the most important thing, especially in the exams. Whenever we are frequently failing, we should have patience. We have the capacity to wait. Because in Quran, it was said that, Inna Allah ma sabiri. Sabr means patience. So the patience, these ideologies, these religious practices, it is not only for teaching in the madrasas or in the masjid. It should be in our every daily life practices. As your introducer Shahid maybe told you that in every sphere of life, we have some Islamic duties. So our ultimate quality would be positive. Our ultimate quality would be patience. We have to wait until the result comes. In Bhagavad Gita, there is a concept of nishkama karma. It means you have to only work and the result is not up to your hand. Whether you will get benefited, whether you may not, it is not up to your hand. It is a godly practice. So our duty is make best effort, try and try again, and at the last you would be qualified. So there is a ultimately, I think my time is over. I give you concluding with one word of Quran. Inna Allah la yughayyiru ma biqawmin hatta yughayyiru ma bi anfusihim. Allah will never change a community until they are changing internally themselves. So if the community is going on the east side, Allah will never change them to the west until they have the capacity, internal capacity to change themselves to the west. So it is up to our intention, it is up to each one's quality, confidence, patience. We have to create the situation. Then the second term Allah will help us. So for all of us, I think all of you are came for aspiring the exams of UPSC. You have all the space in the country. I think we have the Muslims in the country is 14%. And in the civil services, it is less than 4%. So there is a gap of 9%. Who will fill the gap? Only Kerala and Jammu Kashmir students, they are getting the adequate space from our community. What about the other states, especially the Hyderabad or Telangana? So it is under your control, under your capacity, under your work, the community has a long style of empowerment. So the coming youth, we have a ray of hope, as per I have already told, tu shahi hai, parwaz hai ka matera, tere samne asman aur bhi hai. Now your job is to fly and study hard. Fly for a student is to study hard. No need to bother about any expectation, any result. Your duty is just exclusively study for the purpose, and ultimately you are winning. Everything will happen, and all the best for you. Assalamu alaikum.